For question number 152, the correct option is option number 4. And to show how we arrive there, some steps of solution. I draw a quick figure. This is the ground on which a solid sphere is rolling towards the right with a constant center of mass velocity. So as the solid rolls, there is a combination of two motions. One is translational motion of the center of mass. So if I call the center for this uniform sphere as center of mass, that is, the corresponding velocity of center of mass, I am calling it as VCM, this vector. In addition to this translational motion of center of mass, the solid simultaneously rotates about a horizontal axis passing through the center of mass with a constant angular velocity, say omega. So once again quickly from this figure, a rolling motion typically is a combination of two motions. One is translational motion of center of mass with a velocity of VCM and a simultaneous pure rotational motion of the body about a horizontal axis passing through center of mass with an angular velocity of omega. So accordingly, it has got two types of kinetic energy. We are doing step number one here with a figure. One is translational kinetic energy, I am calling it KT, T for translational. That is given by half into M into VCM square. That is my equation number one. We assume the mass of the sphere is capital M, its radius is capital R. Let me write somewhere, assume mass is M and radius is R. So translational kinetic energy is half M VCM square, and at the same time it possesses rotational kinetic energy KR, given by the formula half into ICM into omega square. That is my equation number 2. In the second formula, ICM is moment of inertia of the sphere about this axis to center of mass. Omega is its constant angular velocity as shown in my figure. That is step number 1. Now in step number 2, we recall that for a solid uniform sphere, moment of inertia about an axis to center of mass is given by the formula 2 by 5 mr square, where m is the mass of sphere, r is its radius. Step number 3, we recall the non-slip condition of rolling. That's important. When there is no slip at the bottom of the sphere with the ground, I say again, as the sphere rolls, there is no slipping or skidding happens between the bottom of the sphere and this ground. In that case, the condition for that is center of mass velocity VCM should be equal to the radius of the sphere R into its angular velocity, that is omega. Now when I use these two conditions, two formulas in equation number 2, what do we get? In our next step, we return to this equation number 2 and substitute ICM and VCM. So, from equation number 2, we can write down that rotational kinetic energy KR is equal to half into ICM is 2 by 5 MR square, and omega is, well, you can see here, if VCM is equal to R into omega, omega is coming out to be VCM divided by R. So you put that here, that is VCM by R, this quantity is whole squared, isn't it? It's giving me 2 by 5, well, first there is a half, let me show that in one step only. These two and these two cancelling out, here R square and here also R square cancelling out, we are having 1 upon 5 into M into VCM square. I'm calling it equation number 3. And this form of rotational kinetic energy is comparable to the form of KT in equation number 1. So, in my next step, we can compare easily. Looking for here the ratio transitional kinetic energy divided by the sum of transitional kinetic energy and rotational kinetic energy. So numerator is, from equation number 1, half m into vcm square divided by half mvcm square plus kr, from equation number 3, 1 upon 5 mvcm square. From all the terms, mvcm square cancelling out is coming out to be half upon half plus 1 by 5, that is half upon, you can check it, it's coming out to be 7 upon 10, that is 1 by 2 into 10 by 7, 2 cancelling off, ratio is coming out to be 5 upon 7, and that was the option number 4. So the ratio is 5 by 7, and the option we choose is option 4. That is the end of this question.